Hey Shocks, welcome back to another episode of The Witcher 3, where we are going through White Orchid and just discovering everything that we did not discover until now. There's just one new quest that apparently popped up, so we will check out this one and then move over to the mill, check out the place of power and that undiscovered location, and just in general see what we missed so far in this area. All right, let's go. We now have, again, two swords. I decided, even though it has less raw power, like raw damage, we will be a witcher that will stick to his two swords and not just take any axe he finds on a chopping block and try to kill the monsters with that one. That's not how we roll. We are an old school witcher that uses his two swords. All right, so, and also we got our silver sword repaired as much as we could. So I think now we should be ready to face all the adventures that White Orchid has for us. So let's get started and figure out what we missed so far. I remember in one of the first episodes battling the enemies over here. That was pretty fun. And at that point pretty challenging because I had no idea how the battle system works. And we're just gonna ignore those wolves. They're just not worth it. Especially in this area because they're just too low level. And I just die with one hit off my horse basically. And depends if that one wolf followed me. No. Oh, he might have. So he will die then. Come here, wolf. You want to die? You shall die. Told you. Yeah, I still have to figure out how to. Still have to figure out how to dodge them. With the small dodges. Oh, that one. Oh wow, they really hurt if there are too many of them. Ouch. Yeah, this was like, I am wasting a lot of my food for those useless wolves. So that didn't go as expected nor as I liked. I get some honeycombs and burn down that. Get some, I mean the livers apparently give me 4 raw meat, which is not bad, which is pretty good actually. Still, I had to eat like 4 pieces of meat just to like recover from that. And is this one, oh, I think this is one of the places we already discovered. That is where we slayed that wraith, isn't it? I think that is that place. All right, let's move to that quest marker that we were here for and see what quest there is.
Whoa, Master Witcher!
Hey, merchant, how can I help you?
What happened?
Monsters from the swamp. Folk said the road was fraught with peril, but I wouldn't listen. Got my comeuppance now.
Less moaning, more details. What happened, and how can I help? And remember, I don't work for free. Witcher's code and all.
Ah, you made that very clear.
Well, was on my way to the Black Ones to trade. Suddenly my horse got spooked, ran clear off the road. We hit a bump, I went flying and the horse and cart rolled on. Then I heard bubbling, neighing, slurping. Something came out from the muck. Devoured Asher, hooves and all. No doubt my goods are still on the cart, but I'm too afeard to go and see. Thought maybe you. I'm most concerned about a little box. Bring it to me, I beg you.
Huh. I mean, it sounds interesting.
Fine,
but
I'll go. Let you know if I find that box.
It sounds like dangerous. when it swallowed the whole forest, if I understood that correctly. And are there any things I can loot on the way here? I don't think so. So, let's see, where do we have to go? It should be somewhere around here. I do not have a quest marker. Let's look at the quests. Secondary quest, precious cargo, there you go. Let's track the quest. But it must be somewhere here. Okay. I mean, there's no monster or anything here yet that I would have to fight. What's in there? It's like a broken down house. What is this? Ingredients. A few explosive barrels. Oh, there. Okay, the horse took a turn in there. And there's some loot. No, those are just explosive barrels again. Alright, so there are those dudes again. Those aquatic dudes. Alright, so there's the horse carriage. I got their attention. Did it hurt them? No, it didn't? Really? I did. Alright, one after another. That's how I like it. Oh, I do not have any more of those. So, alright, one after another.
Damn it.
Two down and three to go. Let's see if we. Yeah, that guy. Not too greedy. You're dead. Alright, now you come. Oh, really? I totally dodged him. Alright. Sigh. How far are we back? Alright, we're just here. I mean, yeah, those drowners are pretty brutal. Oh, and already... I don't have any of my... any of my bombs anymore. So I guess we start with the... we can actually start with this, the Igni sign. I'll just do that. Ah, that was way too short. Alright. Alright, crap. Did not get hit at all, too. Ah, wow, this is embarrassing. Come on! I can beat those. I just have to be much more careful. I have to like pick one after another. And yeah, my plan was to just go in and hopefully be able to, let you know, explode that barrel there. But that didn't work. So let's see if we can shoot them. Usually, like, goes underwater. Back. Right, let's see if we can lure one of them out after another. I don't think those bolts do any damage to them. That's the problem.
What now, you piece of filth?
Alright, my first successful normal dodge. But yeah, I can't keep attacking because they will just hit me anyway. Right, he didn't drop anything. So let's try that again before the others show up. Can I get your attention, sir? Just with a small bow to the face? No? Maybe you. Small bolt to the face? Alright, two are very dangerous, so let's just roll out of the way. Let's see if we can... Yes.
Damn it.
Yeah, literally, damn it. Yeah, get away. Alright. Oh, crap, I thought he was dead. Wow. A little heart attack moment here. Alright, another two down. So it was good that I used my sign there. That protected me from a bunch of damage. I think it's one of the most useful signs, the shield here. And let's just burn down the pipe. Get some money. Well, indirectly, we're collecting what's left. And back to the shield. So I thought there were more drowners. There's just one more drowner. Alright, come here. Oh, come on, I totally went out of the way. I guess too late. Alright. Yeah, I guess the harder the enemies get, the more I have to learn to do that normal dodge, like that, that's using on the jump key, to do that dodge. Because the rolling away dodge is okay, but if you have a lot of enemies to face, there is, you know, you have to do a lot of rolling, and it's better and faster just to just do that jump to the side and hopefully I'm able to do a counterattack.
Didn't mention this. Interesting. I should take a look around.
So there, yes, someone attacked it. And that is maybe the person we saw before.
Carts riddled with arrows.
So there are a bunch of arrows around. Who's that guy?
Square in the neck. Good shot. Either the merchant's got serious memory problems, or he's lying.
Interesting. Can I loot you? Or why is it glowing orange? Alright. So that's interesting. They were ambushed down here or something went on. Find a little box of merchant. Oh, okay, so there's another box. And let's burn down that well. While we're waiting, we can collect a few flowers as well, or alchemy ingredients. So where's that box? What's not in the bush? All right. So yeah, can I loot that guy? I don't think I can. Oh, there is that the box he was talking about? Yeah.
Must be that box he mentioned. Splattered with blood. Human blood.
So this is weird. So basically the horse carriage drove off the road in here. And they get attacked with people that had very good aim with arrows. Or he shot his buddy. Interesting. Alright, let's save just for good measure before I screw it up again and just die. Like I did right a few seconds ago. So, merchant, what's your real story?
Oh, and you find the box?
Yeah, found your priceless chest. And someone who looks an awful lot like a cart driver with an arrow through his neck. No dryads in these swamps, and never known a drowner or a water hag to use a bow. So lacking any other suspects, I'm guessing.
Watch out! Behind you!
There's nothing behind me. I'm a witcher, I'd have heard it. Just like I can hear your heart, which is pounding, like a liar's. Best hope you're a better rider than you are a liar.
Oh, are we gonna chase him? Come on, let's chase him. Just for the sake. I mean, we don't really get anything out of it, but hey, you can't lie to us. Alright, Mark. Roach, let's go. Let's go, come on. We can get him. Alright. So, do we just kill him? Or we do? Yeah, we kill him. And say goodbye to your head, bro. Boom! You come on, shall not lie to us.
Gotta get him out of here. Wake up. See? Can't run from the truth. Not even on horseback. Now who are you, and why'd you attack that cart?
Private First Class John Gamer. Temerian 6th Division, 2nd Regiment. Disbanded, but still active. Underground, in the woods. That was a medical transport. I'd be damned if it reached the Black Ones. And the medicine. Our lads could use it too. We've many ill among us. You let me go, and they might live and fight once more for a free North.
We kinda have a few allegiances with the North, so... But I still want to get paid, you know? The medicine stays with me.
You can go, but I'm keeping the medicine. Nilfgaard will find you and kill you anyways. Why should it go to waste?
Damn right.
Take it, and choke on it.
Nah, I try not to. Yeah, but I prefer to choose who gets the medicine.
It's true what they say about witches.
And yeah, I don't really care about your opinion. All right, back to... Oh, that's convenient. We're right next to the herbalist, so we can go to her and get rid of all of our honeycombs. And then we will check out the other side of the river, see what's going on there, if there are a few monsters we can mess up and see what we missed. Hello.
Yes.
We got... stuff for sale, but who is Claire?
Listen, ever heard of a woman named Claire? Lived around here?
Heard of her? A mild way to put it. Claire was a friend. The only person dear to me in all of White Orchard. Until her husband, Volker, quarreled with the Lord of the Manor. He then gathered the family, moved out into the woods to start a new settlement. The Lord and his retinue rode there to convince them to return. They were to be civil. No forcing. No bloodshed, but you saw. Word is Claire said something about the Lord's son, Florian. Something that made the Lord furious. But who knows the truth?
Lots of misfortune for such a small village.
'Tis so in every village. Even the smallest. You need only ask. But let's not end on a teary note. Here, a bit of solace.
Huh, what do we get? We did get 10 crowns. Soul Pater, did we just complete a quest or something? I mean, so Claire was one of the wraiths we defeated. It was the Midnight Wraith, or however it was called. That was the one where we went down into the water to find her ring. And to slay the wraith and then make sure she doesn't come back. So she apparently knew her.
Yes.
Alright, this is very interesting. I really like the story and these seemingly, to me at least, random encounters. Like, I don't think it was actually a quest to go to her and ask her about it. So I really like the
storytelling. I'm sure
I'd find something.
All right, so what do you sell? Let's look at this. Lessiglyph of Quen. Place an empty socket on a piece of equipment to prove its traits. Quen is which one again?
Farewell.
Let me check. Quen is the protective shield. I might actually get that one. That's one of the few ones that make absolute sense
to me. Got any herbs you're willing to sell?
And actually, let's see what. I think one of my boots still supports that. So. Oh, so the in the brackets, it's a sum. So I do not have enough money to even buy those. Sadly, no. I would have loved to have that one. So we have here a white gull. It's a hallucinogen. Interesting. And this is just an ingredient. I'm tempted to buy those just to have those. Troll decoction regenerates vitality during and outside of combat. I still have to figure out how exactly those work, like all the alchemy things and how the decoctions and concoctions work. So far, I'm not going to buy those. Where are the honeycombs that I want to sell to her? Drown a brain. Not worth a lot. But yeah, where are those? Silver? It should look yellowish, right? Am I just blind and don't see them? Necroclaw, water essence, drown a brain. I get tons of things here, but where are all the... Oh, there the honeycombs. All right. So actually, they do regenerate vitality, but they are worth 18 apiece. So I shall sell all of them to you. Oh, that is actually a bunch of money. Oh, the merchant doesn't even have enough money to give to me. Well, that's fine. So do I have enough money to buy that off of you? No. Oh well. Let's actually check the.
Got any herbs you're willing to?
I'm sure.
Let's actually check the alchemy page. What interesting things we can do. Alcohest, just an ingredient. What's a simum? Blinds opponents with its explosive radius. Destroys monster nests. That is actually very, very tempting. So the dancing star. Does 100 fire damage. Devil's Puffball does 100 poison damage. Oh, this one is actually pretty good against monsters. It's plus 350 silver damage. So that would have been amazing against those drowners. What am I missing? Well, I'm missing calcium equal. And for Samoom I can craft right now, I think. And I think I do that. Because that sounds really good against a group of enemies. And for the grape shot, I need calcium equum. So let's see if she actually sells that. How did that look? Calcium equum. We need it. Let's check. We need two. So let's buy two. Nice. So I just have to not forget to actually use those and switch those around. But otherwise, I really like the different ingredients here, or the different bombs here. Decoction. Each sign cast increases stamina regeneration from the remainder of the fight. All right, so these decoctions enhance Well, actually, they do pretty nice things. I have to go through those at some point and figure out if they're any useful to the style of combat that I do. It's probably just pretty bad combat to begin with. These ones, just potions, just make you stronger, I think. They just accelerate stamina, increase attack power. Nice. And oils. Oils, yeah, seem to just increase the effects of my swords. So if I have to fight cursed necrophages or specters, I should put those oils on it to make them more efficient. But for now, I think that's it. And it is farewell for now. And we will continue our journey to the next undiscovered location. And that is behind, like, going over the Wosong Bridge up to this undiscovered location. What will we find? See you right after commercials break. Nah, just kidding. Alright, Roach, come here. We gotta go. We have a mission. A mission to discover those areas and fight all evil in there. Oh, so where's the bridge? We have to take one of the bridges. So we might as well take that bridge over there. Because that's the only one that I see. There are two horses without any owner. I wonder what happened to those guys or girls. Come on, get over the bridge. That cost me my life before when the horse decided to stop right in front of the bridge while two drowners were just sitting next to it. And like the drowners just pushed me off and... Oh! That deserter's back? Huh.
Don't let him catch his breath!
Oh man. He actually deflected it. Nice, that's the first time I saw that. There's no one back here. I don't know if I forgot the guy the last time or he's just one lonely deserter that's left. Ah, come on. Yep, there's a lot of blood in that one. And wow, he like actually blocked it twice. Your skin but that was it.
Take it easy.
So let's see what he has on him and why were you attacking me? He was just literally randomly standing here with an empty bottle and a hatchet and trying to kill me. All right. Let's see what there is at that point that we didn't discover yet. Come on, just keep running, horse. Don't get confused by the roads. Let's go into the backcountry and see what we find here. Okay, so this is a... Wow, like 1,000 wolves again. A wider circle around here just to make sure we get those wheels. Wow, there are a ton of them. So yeah, the best approach is just to do super wide circles around them and then just hit them one after another. And just hope we don't get into too big of a nest of wolves, so they will overpower us. Oh, missed that one. Oh wow. Yeah, that's what I mean. Like if they're like four or five of them, that might just be too much for. There's one ahead of us. Take care of that one too. While we're at it. Oh. But those are not our main concern of the other wolves over there are. Oh god, there are like 100 of them. This is crazy. And he actually dodged it, or we just were too early in releasing it. So that one goes. And yeah, we just have to go. Oh wow, that hurt. But yeah, I don't know why there are like 100 of them. And yeah, the horse's stamina also is about to run out. And a lot of them are chasing us. Let's turn around and try that again. Right, come on. Oh, I hate that. Why the fuck do you put your weapon away? God damn it. This, like, auto. The game is so intelligent, it does things for me. Stop it, game. You're stupid. You're incredibly stupid. You do not know what I'm gonna do, so stop doing stuff for me. You think you know what to do. Alright, come here, come here. Go die. And I'm gonna dodge. Ah, oh, damn it. I have to learn how to, like, see when they actually attack me. I'm actually faster killing those wolves just by being off the horse. Alright, there were more. There were a bunch of them. Bunch more. So... Ah, god, come here, Roach. Jesus Christ.
Come here, what now, you piece of hell?
Yeah, I literally catch every attack a wolf tosses at me. It is horrible. Let's go to that wolf and see if we can actually just dodge his attack for once. That would be incredibly good. Where is he? The warg would actually be pretty good because... Yeah, so sometimes actually my attacks will basically kind of stun them a bit or like deter them from attacking. But sometimes, even though if I just hit them a second ago, they will, you know, immediately afterwards be able to attack me. So I just have to be prepared to dodge them. There's another one that I killed before while I was on the horse. Get away, Doc. God, they hurt. I have to start dodging more. Otherwise, I go through so much food. It's not even fun. All right, let's actually go back to the place that we came to explore. What is here? What happened here? They're like a bunch of shields and armor, but nobody to wear them. There's a bunch of loot. Well, let's check it out. Scrawl notes. Oh, and tons of armor. That is nice. Like, but let's check out the notes. What happened here? Where are the scrawl notes? Unsent letter. Mikkel. Letter to Yennefer. So I think those are all the contracts. Where is that? Oh, there. Scroll notes. Things are going better and better for us. We've pitched camp in the heart of the forest near the old mill and have already done quite nice for ourselves. Folk are poor, so they say, but squeeze them and something always pops out. Sack of grain here, a few crowns there. Not bad for easy work. Certainly better than the army. At least we got something to fill our bellies. And the risk that we'll pay for this all with our lives? Well, it's still less than when we charging the Nilfs at Nutlis' order. Well, that's certainly true, but someone found you. Or took care of your business, so to say. And yeah, now I'm gonna take care of all the loot you have. Don't mind me. I'm gonna redistribute it to the people who need it, like myself. And that's about it. Alright, there's a bunch more loot to be gathered here. Goat hide. Oh, stop hitting stuff. Nope. Cannot destroy this. Stop it. And anything else? I can loot the ones in the back as well. That is really nice. Ashes. I don't know what, like, why would they store ashes? Like, I guess for alchemy purposes? But if you're like, you know, someone who's clearly not a witcher, like, you're just robbing people or, like, squeezing stuff, like, out of people, out of poor people, like, why do you keep ashes? Alright, so let's clean up all the dogs here, or the wolves. Let's eat more meat because we're still not at full health, and I dare to say we have to buy food to not die out here from those wolves. Because I am horrible at combat and have to clearly improve that if I want to get through the game, I think. And I thought I saw something up there, so let's check out what is up there. But that will have to wait to the next episode. So make sure to join us to figure out what is up there on the hill and for more adventures. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.